and welcome to the third session of this chapter polynomials. Let us see some more problems here. Coming to the seventh problem of similar kind, draw the graph for y is equal to 6 minus x square and find zeros from that. So we have to draw the graph for y is equal to 6 minus x square. How do we draw that? We follow the similar process explained in the previous problem. We will go for a table wherein you will have x first, yx because it has this variable. This is not at all taken into consideration because all its value is taken as y, so that will take down. So the variable is x, therefore you will take x here in the first line and you will draw a double line. After drawing the double line, you will take the first term, next second term including the symbol, next third term including the symbol minus x square. Now all these will be taken and finally once they are all completed, you will draw a double line and then another line will add. So this is all we got. So the final one we will name it as y. Now as discussed, we will take 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. This is how we draw the table. Right, so you draw the double line there and here a double line and then go on to fill in the box. Now what to do? The first one is 6. You see symbol is plus, so you take plus 6. So now it has nothing to do with the value of x because it is just 6. So you go on to put 6 like this one, plus 6, plus 6, plus 6. So whenever you have a constant term, you will put it as it is. The next one says minus x. That means in this you have to substitute the value of this one. So minus x means minus 0. So minus 0 is what? Nothing but 0. Then what about this one? You will put 1 in place of x. So minus for this one and 1 for x. So it is minus 1. So like this it will become minus 2, it will become minus 3. Now how about this one? So it is actually minus x means minus comes from this. And x value is minus 1. So it's minus 1. So when you have both symbols, you will put a bracket. Now minus into minus is plus 1. So its value becomes plus 1. So plus 2 and plus 3 like this. Now what about this one? See, this is minus x square. Means take 0 and put it in place of x. So minus will be like that only. And 0 will be there here. And you multiply. See, minus comes from this one. See, minus comes from here, so that will be as it is, and in place of x you will put substitute all these. So 0 square is 0, minus 0 is nothing but 0, so you anyhow end up getting 0. Next, minus x square, you will put 1. So minus is minus and 1 square, so minus will be like that only. 1 square is 1, so it is in all minus 1. So next, minus x square, in that you minus is minus and in place of x you have to put 2. So 2 squared is 4. So minus 4. So this way you get minus 4 and this becomes minus 9. Now let us see how we put this one. So it is minus x square. So minus comes from here as it is. And in place of x you have to put minus 1. So minus 1 squared. Minus 1 squared. Whenever you have an even power, minus turns to become plus. So plus 1 squared is 1. So now this is multiplied by minus. So minus into plus is minus, 1 is 1. So this will get minus 1 and minus 4 and minus 9. So this way we filled all the data. Now I'll tell you why we have drawn double line. This is only to avoid confusion. It is not a rule. So that you will only do the simplification with those in between these double lines. So these and these. Because if you don't draw a double line, you may go on to add this one also at some point. So only to avoid this, it is just like the road divider which saves you from accident like that. So here plus 6, 0, 0 is plus 6. You will add those with same symbol, so it will become minus. So minus 2 plus 6 is plus 4. Next, minus 2 minus 4 is minus 6, plus 4 is 0. Minus 3 minus 9 is minus 12, plus 6 is minus 6. Minus 1 plus 1 is 0, so this is plus 6. So here 6 plus 6 plus 2 is 8, 8 minus 4 is 4, 6 plus 3 is 9, 9 minus 9 is 0, Like this, you will go on filling the table. Once this table is finalized, you will take the values of the x and the y and make them as a coordinates of a point. So 0, 6, 1, 4, 2, 0, 3, minus 6, minus 1, 6, minus 2, 4, minus 3, 0. Like this, we have to write the coordinates and then go for drawing the graph. You have to remember one thing. In the last row, you must be able to get two zeros. Then you are said to have got two zeros for that. So where it is zero, there this is the zero of the polynomial. Where it is zero, this is the zero of the polynomial. Of course, there may be cases where you will not get zeros at any cost. That you can decide using graph. Now let us go to the graph. So let us think this is the graph. Now depending on the values of y, this y axis may need to be taken on a scale like 1 centimeter square, 2 or 5 sometimes. It depends on the values here. Here the maximum and minimum values are minus 6 and plus 6. So I have taken up to 6 here and minus 6 here. So there hasn't been a need for taking scale. Now let us identify the point. 0, 6. 0, 6 is this one. 1, 4. 1, 4. 2, 0. This one. 3, minus 6. 3, minus 6 is here. So minus 1, 6. Minus 1, 6 here. Next, minus 2, 4, minus 2, 4 here. Next, minus 3, 0, minus 3, 0 here. And that's it. Now, this is a quadratic equation. Definitely, a quadratic equation will be giving you a graph in the shape of a parabola. It will be a gold chain taken from your neck. So, it will be like this, a cup-like shape. So, it may be like this. Are upside down like this or sideways like this, but it will be something like this, a U shape. So let us see if you observe it, it is in this shape. So you have to join these like this. And don't stop at the last point, just go a little bit using a narrow mark and leave it like this. So now this is the parabola we got. So here what is important is, don't draw lines with this using scale like this. This is wrong. You have to draw a soft curve joining them. It should appear like you are going on your way on the train, and on your way these points happen to meet you. It should not appear that you are going for that point. It should appear like you are going on your way, and on your way these points happen to meet you. This is how we draw a line. And this is very wrong. Drawing double lines is wrong. It should be a single line. Because my pen was not writing properly, I had to draw it again. So joining using scale is wrong here. So this is how we draw a graph for this one. Now what is the conclusion we can make? As discussed, whenever this graph touches x-axis, there the coordinates of x are called the zeros of the given polynomial. So here it is touching the x-axis at minus 3 and plus 2. So here minus 3 and plus 2 are the zeros of the given polynomial. You can substitute and check it. So usually they will be like this or in any way. But where it touches the x-axis, that is the zero of the polynomial. Now you have to write like this. On plotting the graph using these coordinates, the graph has been a parabola. It was touching the x-axis at two points where minus 3, 0 and 2, 0 here. The x coordinates are minus 3 and 2. Therefore, the zeros of the polynomial are minus 3 and 2. This is how we have to write. For example, you may have a case like this, where the graph will be like this, a parabola, but not touching x-axis. Then what? That means, it is not touching x-axis means, it has no zeros. Yes, there may be some cases where no matter what value you put here, that never becomes zero. So, in that case, we can simply say it has no zeros. So, that kind of cases may also arise. In that case, we simply write like this. On plotting the graph with the given points, the graph has been a parabola, not touching the x-axis at any point. So, we can say it has no real roots. This is how we explain it. And for example, it may touch the x-axis only at one point, sometimes only at one point like this, at a single point. In that case, it has only one zero. So you said it will have as many zeros as its degree is. Yes, I said the maximum number of zeros will be equal to its degree. The maximum means it will be highest, but it can also be less than that. So when its degree is 2, it may have 2 or 1 or 0 like this. So it may have 2 zeros like this, or 1 zero like this, or no zero like this. Anything may happen. This is what you have to remember. And there is one more point you may come across and get confused in examinations. For example, this graph happens to come up to this point and end here. Now, can you say it has only one zero? Because you must be able to imagine, okay, it has come down, it is going on, and there is no chance for it to come back, so this will go. But here, as it is coming down, there is a chance for it to come down, yes or no? So you can't draw up to this point and say there is only one zero. So you have to extend it. So how to extend it? You do not know where to go, like this or like this. In that case, you have to extend the numbers in the table. How? For example, for this to come down, this should have the values like minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. So you have to increase minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 are already there. So you'll increase maybe one more number like minus 4, minus 5. Then automatically you get the values, and finally that goes and touches the x-axis. So depending on the shape of the graph, you have to decide whether to increase positive values or negative values, so that it touches the graph at x-axis, at two places. Now in this case, no matter what the values you increase for x, they will only go upside, upside, upside and upside, but they never come down. So there is no use in extending the values here for this kind of graphs. But where, if you have a case like this, if you have a graph like this coming and stopping here, then you have to increase the positive values of x here, then this will automatically come and go like this, touching the x-axis 2 points. This is very important. Now let us go to the 8th problem. How many zeros does the graph p of x have from this one? So a graph is given like this. The values are not given and they don't matter at all. It is given like this, like this, like this, like this, and like this, and like this. So he's asking how many zeros does the p of x have according to this graph. So can we say how many zeros a polynomial can have based on its graph? Yes, we did it just now. When the graph touches the x-axis, there the value of x is a zero. So it is touching x-axis at one point, and here also it was touching, here also, and here also. So finally it is touching the x-axis at 5 points. So it must have 5 zeros. So this polynomial must be a 5th degree or 6th degree or higher. But definitely its degree will be minimum of 5. So it will have 5 zeros. So we have to say, because the graph is touching the x-axis at 5 points, it will have 5 zeros. This is our answer. Now let us look at the 9th problem. Find the zeros of 2x square minus 9x plus 10. Verify the relationship between coefficients and zeros. What? How to find the relationship between coefficients and zeros? Let us find out the first part first. It says, find the zeros of the polynomial. How to find the zeros of the polynomial? You have just learned in the other session. So you will just equate it to 0. Yes. Then multiply the first term and the last term and write it here in the rough. So 2 tens are 20. So plus into plus is plus 20. X square for x square. So this is what we have to write. Then leaving the symbol aside, I asked you to write it as a product of 2 factors. So it can be written as 1 into 20, 2 into 10, 4 into 5. Am I right? So now you have to make addition of this pair, any of the pair, in order to get the middle term. What is the middle term here? It is 9. Forget about minus, we'll think of that one later on. So it is 9. You have to get 9 on adding any of the numbers of the pair. So 20 plus 1, 1 plus 20 is 21, not equal to 9. 2 plus 10 is 12, not equal to 9. 4 plus 5 is 9. Therefore, this satisfies our condition. So 4 and 5 are required. Now, because we have to add, they both will have the same symbol. But what is that same symbol? Do they both have plus or do they both have minus? Who knows? That is decided by, again, this man. So this man is minus. So both should have minus symbol. Now, minus 4, minus 5 gives you minus 9. So this is how you decide. So adding means having the same symbols. Which symbol to have? If it is same, the symbol that is given by the middle term. So this is required now. So we'll put this x for this one, x for this one. And this is how you split the middle term in two. So now you write it. So 2x square, instead of this one, you write this one, minus 4x minus 5x plus 10, 10 for 10 is equal to 0. Sir, does it make any difference if you change the order? No matter. Whether you write minus 5x and minus 4x or minus 4x and minus 5x, the order does not matter. Don't worry. Now, if you observe carefully, 2x can be taken common. So if 2x is taken common, x will be here and minus 2 will be here. So what is there inside the brackets? You write it again. So now, as told you, these two have formed this one. So these two should come from this one. So if you take out this one from the first term as told earlier, what remains is minus 5. If you put minus 5, that does the job. Now, what happens? X minus 2 is present in both the cases. So you write it x minus 2 taken common. So separated by into, you have 2x here. So 2x and minus 5 here. So is equal to 0. Now from this we get either this must be equal to 0 or this must be equal to 0. Nani emaitundi beta ayipoyinda inko. Either this must be equal to 0 or this must be equal to 0. So let us think x minus 2 must be equal to 0 or 2x minus 5 must be equal to 0. In case if this is 0, x must be equal to 2, or if this is 0, 2x must be equal to 5, and from this x must be equal to 5 by 2. Now this is a 0 and this is another 0. So the two zeros for this polynomial are 2 and 5 by 2. 2 and 5 by 2. Now these are the zeros. So first part of the question is completed. Find the zeros of the polynomial. And is asking us to verify the relationship between coefficients and zeros. Is there any relationship between the zeros and the coefficients? What are the coefficients here? Now if you compare it to the standard form ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So the coefficient of x square is called a. So a is equal to 2. Coefficient of x is called b. So b is equal to minus 9. The constant term is called c. So c is equal to 10. Is there any relationship between this and this? Let this first 0 be alpha and next 0 be beta. So the first 0 be alpha, next 0 be beta. Now, if first 0 and second 0 are added, that will be equal to minus b by a. This is one important thing you should remember. That means if you add two zeros, it will be equal to minus b by a. What is minus b? So minus is somehow from the formula. B is the coefficient of x. So we can also write minus coefficient of x by what is a? Coefficient of x square. So alpha plus beta, sum of roots or sum of zeros, is equal to minus coefficient of x by coefficient of x square. This by this gives you sum of roots. Now let us see, is it really right or wrong? If you take alpha plus beta, let us see what it is. Alpha is 2 plus beta is 5 by 2. If you add them both, it will be 2. So 4, 1 2s are 2, 2s are 4, plus 2 1s are 1 5. So it is equal to 9 by 2. So by actual addition of the zeros, you are getting 9 plus 2. So do we get the same by this formula? Let us see. The formula says it must be equal to minus b by a. Minus comes from this formula. So you write minus. What is the value of b? It is minus 9. You see, this minus is written here as it is. And for the value of b, this minus 9 is written. So minus 9 comes from b. This minus comes from this formula. So when you have two symbols side by side, you will put a bracket then. By a, what is the value of a? It is 2. Now if you take it, minus into minus becomes plus 9 by 2. Is it equal to this one? Yes. So as per the actual addition, it is 9 by 2. From the formula also it is 9 by 2. Hence the relationship is verified. And is there anything else to prove? Yes, there is one more thing. If you add them, it is equal to this by this. If you multiply them, it will be equal to this by this. Simple. If you add them one by one, minus this by this. If you multiply them this by this, that means this means C by this means A. So Let us check it. The product of two zeros is equal to the constant term by the coefficient of x square. So, let us check it. Alpha into beta is equal to 2 into 5 by 2. So, 2 get cancelled, let it is equal to 5. Now, let us check it using the formula. The formula says C by A. What is the value of C here? It is 10. So, 10 by what is the value of A here? 2. So, by 2. 2 5s are 10. So, 5 is 5. 5 is same in both the cases. So, the relationship between the zeros and the coefficients is verified. This is how we find the zeros and then verify the relationship between them. So, for a quadratic equation, if alpha and beta are the zeros, then their sum alpha plus beta is given by minus b by a, and their product alpha beta is given by c by a. Now, let us take a cubic polynomial. A cubic polynomial will be like this: ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. And because it is cubic polynomial, it will have three zeros. Let the zeros be alpha, beta and gamma. Now, is there any relationship between these and the coefficients? Yes, definitely there will be. Because there was a relationship between these, there will be a relationship between these also. Let us see how it will be. It was from ax square plus bx plus c, it was like this. Alpha plus beta is equal to minus this by this, minus b by a. Next, both of them taken together, it was this by this, c by a. Does that apply here also? Let us see. So, let us add them also. Alpha plus beta plus gamma will be equal to the same, this by this. So, this is always a denominator. So, this by this will be the sum of the zeros. So, b by a. But remember, the first one will start with minus. So, minus b by a. Then what if you do c by a? Let us see. What if you do d by a? Let us see. Here it was b minus b by a was plus. C by a was multiplication. Now here, how to do that? Let us see. So when you are taking the first one, you will take 1, 1, 1 each time and add them. When you are taking the second one and dividing by a, you will take 2 each time. So alpha beta ones, beta gamma ones, gamma alpha ones. So all these added, you will get to this one. So alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha gives you c by a. Then what about d by a? Here we are taking 1 each time. So the first one, 1 each time. Second one, 2 each time. Third one, 3 at a time. Alpha, beta, gamma. There is no other option. So alpha into beta into gamma will be d by a. But the symbol alternates. So when it is minus here, it will be plus the next time. And the next time it will be minus. So alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to minus b by a. Alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha is equal to c by a. Alpha beta gamma is equal to minus d by a. Simple. First one by this, 1 each time added. Second one by this, 2 each time added. Third one by this, 3 each time. Added means there are only 3, so no more addition. For example, if there are 4, there would have been like 3, 3, 3 added each time. Thank you and have a nice practice.